Hello and welcome to UTS Library's tutorial on Scopus's Advanced Search, an interdisciplinary database with a focus on high-quality publications. In this video, we will show you how to enter search queries using field codes and Boolean operators to create a more effective search strategy. To access Scopus, go to the library search page. Click on Databases at the top of the page, then search Scopus. Select Scopus and log in with your UTS ID and password. In Scopus, select the Advanced tab. To demonstrate a search, let's use the sample topic, "What are the ethical implications of nanotechnology for healthcare?" Our keywords are ethical, nanotechnology, and healthcare. To begin, we will add ethical in the query string. However, to ensure we get the widest possible coverage, we will truncate ethical by shortening it to ethic and adding an asterisk. This means the search will include articles that use the word ethics, ethical, and ethically. Next, select AND from the list of search operators on the right-hand side. When you scroll over an operator, it will bring up an explanation and an example on how to use it. Now add the keyword nanotech to the query string, truncate it, and select AND. Finally, add the word health and truncate it. As the word healthcare and medical are often used interchangeably, select OR, add the word medic into your search, and truncate it. Because health and medicine are similar concepts, we have nested them in parentheses to keep them together. Now, let's try the search. To review your results, scan the titles and click on View Abstract for more information. A quick way to review all the results abstracts is by selecting Show All Abstracts. To sort through your results easily, use the Sort menu. It automatically defaults to date, but we recommend using Cited by Highest to see highly cited articles. Click on an article title and you can see who the article was cited by and who the article cited. If you need to make any changes to your search, select Edit to modify it. We will narrow our search to find articles that are more relevant by using the field codes limiter on the right-hand side to limit our keywords to only appear in the title, abstract, and keywords of articles. To do so, copy your initial search and delete it. Then, select title, abstract, keyword under textual content. Paste your initial search in between the parentheses and try the search again. Now the results are more relevant to our topic. From the results screen, further refinements can be made to your search using the filters on the left, such as year of publication, authors, subject area, and more. To read the full text, click on Find It. To export articles to your referencing software, check the articles you want, then select Export. As you'll probably be running multiple searches in Scopus, the search history is a quick way to see what you've already tried. Select Edit, then scroll down to your previous searches, which you can edit, remove, or combine. To stay up to date with new articles added to the database that match your search criteria, select Set Alert. We also recommend using Save This Search so you don't have to retype your search each time. To set up the Save This Search or Set Alert functions, you will need to create a free Scopus account. One of the unique features of Scopus is the Search Analysis tool. Select Analyze Search Results to give this a try. When we select Documents per Year by Source, you can quickly find out which journals have published the most articles on this topic over the years. This information can be useful when making decisions such as where or where not to publish. In this video, we covered using the advanced search features in Scopus. Our top 5 tips are: use field codes to find more relevant results, sort results by cited by to make highly cited articles appear first, look at abstracts to quickly evaluate your results, use the search analysis tool to see which journals are publishing the most on your topic, and save your search to keep track of your search strategy. If you have any questions, contact us using the Ask a Librarian link on the library homepage.